I think being connected to the earth, to the animals, really makes such a reality in growing up as a stable human being, because you realize that we are really, we owe who we are and who we become and where the world is going to the simple thing as the earth. And the earth is feeding us, then the animals that continue to do that, our coexistence with the animals. It's all one big family, and we need to learn to appreciate. And if you do that as a child, as a young person, that's very important. That instills with you certain basic values of life. And I think Boys Grow is an extraordinary opportunity for inner Kansas City kids to really get an opportunity to feel nature and to feel the earth. And the kids just don't mind getting into the dirt, getting all the sneakers full of dirt.
No. Isaiah, you mind getting in the dirt?
You like? Yeah.
In 2013, we were homeless. I mean, we had to find a farm, whether it was a temporary or a permanent one, but we'd switch farms for, you know, 2 years in a row. And it's one thing if you're kind of running a small garden plot, but we're running multiple acres of food production. And to have to switch a third time in 3 years is going to be taxing.
And what's this? This is onions? Yeah.
Honestly, until 3 days ago, this was too wet to really
to do anything. Yeah.
In 2013, we had the fundraiser at her restaurant, and it raised good money, and it also raised a lot of awareness. So I think some of the ripple effect that we got from her supporting us, you know, I think it eventually assisted us in getting this farm.
You know, we used to have the goats, and so my grandmother would give me a metal pillar, like a metal, and we used to nail it down and then give her a leeway and tie her to that instead of holding her, just a nail, and you would tie her around it, and she would go to pasture. When I go back to my childhood, my memories go back to a courtyard with different animal pens, with an extended garden on the other side. And it was labor. It's labor intense, but it was very gratifying. And as a youngster, you know, I assisted in the real work, but I got involved. And so I can't help by reverting back to those memories, to those experiences, to collect fresh peas and eat the peas right off the pods, still in the garden, to pick the perfect fig and just eat it on the tree. I remember, you know, as kids, we used to go on the tree and sit on the limb, on the branches, eat figs, and that was our lunch. You know what we did? When we were finished, there was usually one or two fig trees or whatever, and we had fights, fig fights. It wasn't pleasant, because when mature fig sticks in your hair, you got to cut the hair off. So it wasn't pleasant, but it was fun. A big part of my success is this tight connection, an initial connection that I had with the earth and growing food and appreciating food. Not only do they grow the food, but also harvest it, go and sell it, produce products out of it. Not only that, you know, choose the label, make the label. So it's a progressive learning of being connected to the earth, but also becoming businessmen, little businessmen all the way with the product that the earth gives.
You know, Lidia does her due diligence, and she likes us, and she enjoyed working with us from the start, and I think people see that, where they see that, you know, she gets behind stuff she's very passionate about. So when Lidia says that she enjoys this, I think people take notice.
All right, you're doing a good job. Keep on going, guys.